Hola familia, this week, you know, in all these years I used several different mallets, some of them for carving, some of them for assemble, you know, furniture and all this stuff, and in this case I'm gonna do both in the same video. Probably, well not probably, I'm pretty sure this one can be made from just one piece. Not like this one, which is two different woods. But the thing is, the size that I had from the hard maple don't allow me to do in one piece, so I decided made in two. And in the other hand, I use the assembled mallet in hard maple and hatoba. This is hard maple and mahogany. I mean, the trick or the most interesting part is make it without glue. It's just a nice tight fit and a wedge on the top. That means that if in, for any reason or in any case you break the handle, you can replace it easily. Okay, so let's go to do two mallets.
Well, we are going to begin as always marking the centers on the two blocks that we are going to use as handles. Then the life center is going to be the spur center is going to be mounted. In this case I'm not going to mount it on the axis, just straight onto the chuck, which is perfectly fine, and we are going to make cylinders and establish the spigot, let's say, where we are going to hold it on the chuck. Here we have one, and that's now the other. The position of my left hand is just to don't allow the chips or the shavings to go to my body, right? It's nothing fancy. Okay, now we have to establish, I'm gonna refine a little bit more, and I'm going to establish the dimensions. And then from that point we are going to begin. I'm going to make the spigot that is going to be inserted into the head is going to be 1 inch. So I have to get my calipers in 1 inch, and to do that I'm going to get a parting tool and the calipers and make a couple of grooves with that size that allows me to make the whole spigot in the same size, right? It's, you know, it's an easy process. When you get practice, it's very useful because you don't have to have the caliper on hand all the time. Once it's done, we tray with the caliper if it's right, and then sharpen the edges, and now the handle. I prefer thick handles, so I tray it on my hand how they feel. And then this is an easy shape, easy project. It's not complicated. Anyone can do it as his own way. I tray it again, and once I'm happy with it, I can establish the parting area. And now I'm going to make some grooves that have to, after sanding, that have two reasons. One is just appearance, but the other is to hold it better, to have more grip. And I'm gonna burn it with a steel wire. That's it. And we are ready to part it. I'm going to sand it a little bit and part it apart. Take it apart. And that's it. Finish the knob on the back, and that's it. Here we go. Let's go for the next one. This one, after establish the head, is the same process, exactly the same. so not much more to say here. And now, apart of the size or the shape you gave to the handle, you have to begin by a stop after the spigot, because if not, the head can slice, or you know, can get into the other hand and you know can move. So it's mandatory to have a stop in between the handle and the head. Okay, here we go. This is the head for the assembled mallet. So I marked the center. I didn't record how I make a hole because this is the drill press with a Forstner bit. It's nothing special, so I didn't record it. Here I'm establishing. It's the same process that the handles. And this one with the hole, exactly the same. Don't pay attention to the hole at the beginning, just speed up your lathe. About here I'm working in about 1800 RPM, so the hole is not gonna interfere in any way. Okay, so now you have to establish where you are gonna cut it and measure the same distance to the both sides of the hole to make the head don't balance for one side more than another, so have to be symmetrical. And I always like to make a shape like a barrel. Also in the ends I make a little bit concave. I know that a lot of people prefer it flat, but not, this is not my case, so this is just up to you. Here we go. Just a little bit, enough. In the other hand, of course, you cannot use the spindle gouge, but you can use the parting tool to do the same job. Okay, a little bit of sanding. And now we go to the, let's say, carving mallet, okay? In this case, I'm gonna make the same hole, 1-inch hole, but the difference is, because the length of the Forstner bit, I cannot make the head as long as I want. I'm gonna make it in function or depending of the Forstner bit, right? You have to slow down your lathe. I'm holding the Jacob's jack, but it's not because anything wrong. It's just because when you pull, I don't want that the Jacob's jack get out from the Morse tape, right? It's nothing. It's not to hold it in the turning. And now, usually, I like to do a conic shape and a little bit of concave on the top. That's it. As you can see, there is a little hole where the end of the Forstner bit left. And now we are gonna cut the handle to have a place to position the shim we are gonna use. And for that, you have to hold the handle with a clamp, because you don't want it to turn in your hand. It can be a problem with the bandsaw. So it's much more safe if you handle with a clamp, okay? Now it's just a matter of insert it. As I said, I'm not gonna use any glue. So it's just insert the shim on the top, hammer it, and it's perfectly tight. It's not gonna go anywhere. Now you have a flush saw to cut the excess, and you are ready to go. Final step is gonna be just use a little bit of boiled linseed oil, just, you know, to protect a little bit of wood and to make it a little bit more pretty, let's say. So I'm gonna apply just one coat, to protect a little bit. But of course, always the aspect, the look of the wood change dramatically when you apply any finish to it. It's a beautiful hard maple with a little bit of curly, which is really, really good. I mean, I love it. Here you have some steels. I hope you like it. As you can see, it's not a difficult process, but can be the perfect gift for any other carpenter friend that you have. So, as always, any doubts or comments down below. Don't forget to subscribe, and if you want to help the channel, you have the Patreon button just over there. So I see you next time. Bye-bye.